Okay guys, not long now till the release date, as you'll see off to the left here, 15th of August. So at time of recording of this, 16 days to go. No, 15 days to go. I can't add. It's a weekend. I don't have to add. Anyway, I thought I would take the opportunity to do a little bit of Fall of Cadia. I still have those four elusive stars. There is another update coming and it's rumored. Well, it actually says in the post about it, so it's not really rumored at all, that there are going to be new campaigns. Now, I'm probably not going to be able to undertake both the campaigns, probably not going to be able to complete both the campaigns, even one of them, before the reset, but I'm hyped to try them out, so I thought I would see if I can finish off this campaign first. It's going to be tricky, so this might just end up being a video about filling in the gaps, but we'll give it a go. So this one is a 2-star at the moment, but we've had one character die. We want a 3-star, we want a perfect record. So as you can see here, we've got the 5. We do have a choice of two other Chaos characters. We have a kitten who's very excited by this feather that he's found outside, which we're now gonna throw over there so he can stay away from me while I'm recording. And anyway, so we've got 3 Vox casters. We have a lot of las cannons. So we've got to think very carefully about how we're gonna deal with all this. So we're going to start in this position and we'll see what happens. So whoever goes forward is going to tank a lot of fire to begin with straight away. So we probably want to be a little bit cautious about this. So how are we going to do this? So if we move there, he's not going to be able to kill him. He can shoot at range. Angrax, of course, can't. We kind of want his suppressive fire to go down on these guys here. It's tricky, not gonna lie. All right, I'm gonna drop Angrax forward. He's taken some hits there, he's taken some big hits, and that is what we wanted to happen. All right, we've got the overkill, and that was key. We're now gonna suppress these las cannons, and we're then gonna push forward. Ooh, how are we gonna do this? We're gonna get the kill on this guy. Oh, that was probably a mistake, but we do have a demon summon up and we're going to fire on that one now. That's it. How is this going to go? Hopefully they are going to target. No. Oh no. It didn't go well. It hasn't gone well. So already we failed. We're just going to go for the retry straight away. We can't get the 3 stars, and the 3 stars is what we need right now. So let's try a little bit of a switch around. Maybe put them there. So we're going to start, going to go straight forward. Nobody ran away, which is most inconvenient for me. Alright, we're going to... Woof, alright, he did run away. So we got something there now. Let's go for a quick summon. We've taken those guys out now. We are then going to fire... rapid volley of shots, and that should be enough to kill those next turn. And we're going to push Angrax forward to here. Okay, so the demons being close prevents much damage being done from the las cannon. Alright, so we're going to have to push forward next turn. We have to get these las cannons dead, absolutely dead, as a priority. They have to be killed. One las cannon goes down, and that's a pretty good start for us. Next, we're going to move over here and target down this one. Another las cannon goes down. Next, we're going to fly over here and engage into the middle of this. We're going to go for a big attack. The RNG has failed us. RNGesus has forsaken us once again. Alright. The firepower comes in. We might be alright if we can survive this turn. If all my characters survive this turn, we might be okay here. Oh, Harkon's taken some big hits. Big damage taken by Harkon right there. The las cannon dies. Alright, we get in here again. Priority once again is to kill these guys as much as we can. Alright, he goes in. You're dead now. Get this guy in. You're dead now. Get this guy in. A big hit. Not enough to kill him. Wow. That's harsh. Now we're going to finish you off. And Abaddon can actually win a battle for once. Got it. The RNG gods have not failed us this time, at least. So there's the win. Another star on the old board. But that was the easy one. These two are going to be the harder ones. So this one, as you can see, there are a few las cannons. A few las cannons. They're pretty difficult to deal with. The question is, how are we going to deal with them? That is the real issue right now. So we're going to do a little swap around. I'm going to reposition these guys like so. Okay, we're going to start with that. Okay, so we got 1, 2, 3. As you can see, what we're going to do is use this ability. It suppresses. Oh, one of them ran off. That's actually very good. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. So this guy is going to take a hit whatever happens, but that's fine. 2 hits. Okay, we've got the las cannons there. Next priority is to kill this las cannon if we possibly can. So we're going to just teleport Angrax forward. He's going to tank no hits. I thought he was going to tank a hit. He did not tank any hits. He just does so little damage. It's actually embarrassing. It's actually embarrassing that the so-called warlord can't do anything. But yeah. Oof, the demons are inflicting. Oh, Harkin dies. Harkin dies. He pushes forward and immediately dies. Lovely. God, love that. Wait a minute. What do you mean you don't have to love that? Oh, okay. You know what? Just wasting my time. We're going to retry. We're not going to get 3 stars. So, problem once again. So, maybe what we need to do is sit back, let the rest of these las cannons range forward. So we're going to go do the same thing we did before. We didn't get these guys to flee this time. So the gods of RNG have failed us just a little bit. But we take that one out. That's the priority. Next up, we're going to shoot this guy. Do what we can. He's not going to die, unfortunately. Now it dies. We did get someone to run. So what are we going to do with Angrax? We're going to plonk him here. And we're going to pray for the RNG gods to be generous to us. Okay, copy that. Demons taking. Demons doing the Lord's work there. And by the Lord, I mean Lord Buzz Killington, also known as me. So let's try and take this las cannon out. Oh, he lives. This is so annoying. All right. All right, we're going to sail into the middle here. That didn't go so well for you, Skippy. All right. That one dies at last. So, Obby the Obliterator is going to take some hits here, but I don't care. I just want this guy to die. And we are going to do what we can. We're going to push him forward on the right flank. The firepower comes in. How is this going to go? Oh, this is so close. All right, Harkin should live. He should live through this. Nice. We've got a demon out there. We're going to get in here, kill this guy now. Another las cannon dies. We absolutely need this one to die. It is a priority. Everything must go. He didn't die. Very, very vexing. All right, now die. Thanks so much. Okay, one guy left. Skiddoosh. Alright, there we go. The 3 stars achieved. Made it look easier than I said it was going to be. It's a lot easier than it felt like it was going to be. We are up to 43. Here's the problem. Creed. Creed is problematic. You have to take him out. But getting to him is the tricksy part. So the question is, how are we going to handle this? First off, the obby has to go here, I think. I'm going to tell you why in just a second. Okay, so Obby comes forward. He suppresses these las cannons, and that is critical. They are going to be providing no engagement there. He dies. A las cannon flees. That's actually really critical right there. All right, so let's see what we can do here. This might have been a mistake. We did get one to flee. Oh, he really? He's still around? Okay, whatever. That's fine. We'll get this guy up here to deal with the Voxcasters. Ooh, that's going to land right in the middle there. So, yeah, we're going to have to move the troops around. And I need to get Creed surrounded by demons next turn, if at all possible. Okay, so what we're going to do, we're going to hop him away, kill that guy. I don't really care about him, I just want the space. Okay, all it did was kill Jarman Kel. What's his name? Not Jarman Kel. That's a completely different universe, you guys. I'm sorry about that. Completely different universe. Okay, we're going to get in here and we're going to death strike this guy. We want him to die. Then we're going to move this guy. Ooh, we are going to target Creed.
Creed!
Oh, that was a risk. Okay, there are a lot of demons. There are a lot of demons, so we need these guys. Hopefully we'll be alright here. Creed's attack is going to be absolutely critical in determining what happens here. He summons some more Cadians, which is not optimal. Not optimal, but we are now going to take Creed out. Alright, we got him. You're dead, Skippy. You're not dead? Oh, that's irritating. Alright. You want to die? Thanks so much for that. I really do appreciate it. His ability sucks, it really does. It's not a good ability. The Cadians continue to be persistent. Alright. Now we're cooking with gas. Demon. Alright. Get chopped. Get shot. Get obliterated. Okay, did it. I honestly thought that would be a lot slower than it was, but we got it. Got the job done. Nice. The Fall of Cadia campaign is completed. I did not think it would happen. I did not think it would happen this quickly, but we got some coins. As you can see, we've got some Blackstone. I'm waiting for the next update to do that 10 pull, by the way, guys. 5 rare Imperial badges. That's so useful. And we got some more stuff here. Even more Blackstone, as if I needed any. And let's, shall we spend some of our... Who should we spend it on? Shall we spend it on Vindicta? Or shall we spend it on this guy? He needs XP level 22. Let's spend it on Vindicta. You can never go wrong spending some of these on Vindicta. She does a lot of damage, and it's always good to have that option. Alright, so there you go. Did a little power boost. Not by much, but hey. And let's requisition. This isn't going to be a good one. Oh, okay. 5 shards for Nauseous Rotbone. The Death Guard guy. I forget what he does. Let's have a look. Nauseous. He's the Plague Surgeon, the personal physician of Mortarion, and he is the keeper of the surgical dungeons deep within the Black Manse, wherein the Death Guard keep their stocks of tainted gene seed. Nice. Da-da-da. Oh, he can resurrect fallen units. That's cool. And also, the key thing about this is passive. So, the stronger you make him and keep him in the center, as Chaos characters die, they can come back. I don't think much of his surgical technique. It could use some work. Chippity choppity. But yeah, there you go. So that's it done. Fall of Cadia. Campaign complete. 100% it. Oh yeah. I honestly thought that would take forever. But yeah, you got to strengthen your troops, guys. I focused a lot on Arkham Artis recently. So, as you can see, he's up to silver 1. I'm going to keep trying to strengthen him, and it paid off. So yeah, hope you've enjoyed this. That's the whole Fall of Cadia campaign done now. So yeah, thank you for watching. I will be tackling, as soon as a new update drops, if I have access to it, not forgetting what happened last time, if I have access to a new campaign that I can play, I will start to play some of that for you guys. And yeah, hopefully you will enjoy that. I certainly will. All right, well, without further ado, thank you very much for watching. Like, subscribe, you know what to do. See you in the next video.